everyone. I am Sujani, working as Assistant Professor in Physics at Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Today we are going to see a very basic concept in physics, that is quantum mechanics. Physics is all about study of matter, and we use different theories to explain various phenomena that occur in nature. And one such phenomena is quantum mechanics. Let us see, why do we need to study quantum mechanics? Many emerging technologies need the understanding of quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics played a very important role in photonics, microelectronics, and nanotechnology. Hence, it is very important for engineers and scientists to understand quantum mechanics better. Let us first see the origin of quantum mechanics. We have the Newtonian mechanics, which we call as the classical mechanics. And when things get small, we have quantum physics. And when things are fast, we use special theory of relativity. Now, coming to classical mechanics could explain all the macroscopic phenomena such as the motion of billiard balls to rockets, but it failed to explain the microscopic phenomena. We have now quantum mechanics, which could successfully explain all the microscopic phenomena such as a photon atomic scattering and the flow of electrons in a semiconductor. The behavior of a microscopic particle is very different from that of a classical particle. How the behavior of a microscopic particle is different from a classical particle is, in some experiments, it resembles the behavior of a classical wave. When we say wave, a wave is not localized in space. And in other experiments, it behaves like a classical particle where it is localized in space. Now, the first experiment that talks about the quantized nature of light is black body radiation. So let us look at the black body. A black body is a cavity with a small hole drilled onto it, and the inside of it is coated black. The incoming radiations enter the hole and they keep bouncing inside the box with negligible chance of escaping again. Means it acts as a perfect absorber. When the same black body is heated, it would emit more radiations per unit area at a given temperature. It acts as a perfect emitter. Now, the conclusions that can be drawn from this experiment are, a black body acts as a perfect absorber and also as a perfect emitter. It absorbs radiations of all wavelengths incident on it, and it also emits radiations of all wavelengths. Now, when a black body is at a higher temperature than its surroundings, the emission is more than the absorption, and this heat radiation that is emitted by the black body is called as black body radiation. Black body radiation is a characteristic of temperature, means the radiation varies with temperature, and this radiation also proved the quantized nature of light. Let us now look at the energy spectrum of a black body. The energy emitted by the black body is given by the expression E is equal to 2hc square upon lambda power 5 into 1 upon e power hc upon lambda kt minus 1. Now, when we plot a graph for wavelength versus intensity, for different temperatures, the curve seems to be different, and the curve is not continuous at a given temperature. If you observe the curves for various temperatures, the intensity keeps on increasing. As the temperature increases, the intensity also increases. The intensity of radiation is maximum at a particular wavelength. At T is equal to 3000 Kelvin, this is the maximum intensity. At T is equal to 4000 Kelvin, the maximum is at that particular wavelength. At T is equal to 6000 and at T is equal to 6000. And what we notice here is, as the temperature increases, lambda maximum shifts towards the left. And if we want to calculate the total amount of energy that is emitted at a particular temperature, the area under the curve gives the energy emitted at that particular temperature. The area under this particular curve, T is equal to 300 Kelvin, we can calculate the area. And at T is equal to 6000 Kelvin, we can calculate the area, which shows that as the temperature increases, the amount of energy that is emitted also increases. Now, Planck made two important assumptions to explain the black body radiation. He assumed that the radiations came from the atomic oscillations of the walls of the cavity. Then the radiation is emitted in discrete packets called quanta, and the oscillator absorbs energy in multiples of quanta, and it also emits energy in multiples of quanta. And the energy of each photon is given by E is equal to h nu, where E is the energy that is incident, and h is the Planck's constant, and nu is the frequency of the radiation that is incident. Advantages of Planck's theory are, it explains the energy spectrum of the black body radiation, and it introduced a new concept, that is, energy is absorbed or emitted in discrete packets called quanta, whose magnitude is given by h nu. This concludes the topic of Introduction to Quantum Mechanics. Thank you all for watching.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.